What's up guys, today I'll be showing you the differences between kinetic and energy weapons in Destiny 2. And we're going to take a deep look into where they're better than the other. So first off, we're going to start with two hand cannons. They're both 140 RPM and the same impact, and we're going to see which one does more damage on these red bars. So as you see with the kinetic, it hits 1881. Then with the energy weapon, it hits 1683. And keep in mind, these are the same impact hand cannons. They're just in different slots. Now doing the same thing with body shots, just to make sure it's not different there. As you saw, those were the two numbers, and I'm gonna go ahead and throw all the numbers up on screen real quick. And basically on hand cannons, the kinetic ones do 11.7% more damage than their energy counterpart. Now testing with a few different models, I'm gonna start with auto rifles. And as you see, I hit 464. And then with the energy one, I hit 418. Now the last model I'm gonna test for this video is a sidearm. As you see, they're both 260 RPM with the same impact. And we're going to see the difference. As you saw right there, 1139. Now with the energy, I hit 1023. Once again, throwing those numbers up on the screen. For auto rifles, the kinetics do 11% more damage. And for sidearms, they do 11.3%. So basically, it's all going to be around that 11 to 12% range for the kinetic. And then on shields though, this is where it gets interesting. The kinetic does 147. Now an off element to the shield does 263. Now matching the element using solar, I hit 296. So once again, throwing all those numbers up on the screen, the kinetic does 147 to the shield. Off element does 263, which is 79% more damage. Then with the on element, as in solar, I hit 296, which is 101%, which is double damage. And all this honestly makes a lot of sense, because in the current weapon system where the same models are shared between the kinetic and energy, the energies do twice as much damage on shields. So if they did the same damage on non-shielded targets, why would you ever use a kinetic in the game? They had to make kinetics better against non-shields, that way they'd be useful in some scenario. Because if not, the energy weapons would be just a far superior version of them. I think the interesting thing is to see if they keep this exact same system going into Forsaken with the new weapon changes. For example, once we have snipers and shotguns in our kinetic and energy slots, these percent differences will determine which one you put where. For example, with a sniper, since the whole point of a sniper is to hit crits, you're not really shooting at shields because you can't crit shields at all in this game. You'd probably put the sniper in your kinetic slot, that way you're getting that extra 11-12% damage on your crits. But then something like a shotgun, where you're going to be wanting to break shields and shooting majors with it, you're going to want to keep that in your energy slot. So some of these tiny little things will play a big part into where you put certain weapons with the new weapon slot changes in Forsaken, and I'm intrigued to see how the meta shapes up once that launches. Anyways, thanks for watching, catch you guys next time.